We can find the connected components of a graph rapidly using a depth-first search or a breadth-first search. But these rely on conditional statements executed on every vertex. So while they can be used to find the components of a specific graph, they're harder to use when speaking about graphs in general. But since mathematicians don't worry about computational complexity much, we can consider algorithms that are less efficient but more general. And even if we develop an impractical algorithm, we're still developing an algorithm. Remember, it's not the algorithm, it's the creation of the algorithm, and the only way to learn creativity is by being creative. So in order to create an algorithm, we do need to know something, so let's start with the adjacency matrix. So suppose a graph has adjacency matrix A, then the ij entry of A to the n is the number of length n walks from I to j. So if I and j are in the same component, there's some power k where the ij entry of A to the k is not zero. And this suggests the following. To decide if I and j are connected, look at the ij components of A, A squared, A cubed, and so on. And if any are non-zero, then ij are in the same component. Now remember, an algorithm does have to get to its answer after a finite number of steps. So we need to make sure that there is a point we can stop the computations. So let's think about that. If a graph has n vertices, any walk with length n or greater will revisit a vertex. So we really only need to look at the first n minus 1 powers of the adjacency matrix. And since all entries of all matrices are non-negative, we can look at the sum and see which entries are non-zero. Let's try that. So we have our graph with adjacency matrix, and we note there are 6 vertices, so we can find the first through fifth powers of A. And these will be 6. And so we see that from vertex 1, we can get to vertices 3 and 4. So 1, 3, and 4 are in one component. Likewise, from 2, we can get to 2, 5, and 6. So the vertices 2, 5, and 6 are another component. So the creation of an algorithm typically goes through several steps. We have an idea, we try it out, it looks like it might work, and then we can look for ways to simplify the algorithm. So finding the sums of powers of a matrix is a lot of work. But notice that terms like these appear in the binomial expansion. The difference is there's a leading one, and each power of x is multiplied by some constant. So maybe we can use a similar binomial expansion. And remember, try it out. What's the worst that could happen? Now, since we don't really care if a vertex is connected to itself, the only entries we actually care about are the ij entries with I not equal to j. Suppose I is not equal to j. If the ij entry of the sum of powers of A is 0, then the ij entry of the binomial expansion of I plus A to the n is also going to be 0. So instead of computing n minus 1 powers of A and adding them, we can compute the n minus 1st power of I plus A. So let's consider our matrix. We have I plus A, And the fifth power will be... And from the fifth power of I plus A, we can determine there are walks between vertices 1, 3, and 4, and between vertices 2, 5, and 6. So these are the two connected components. Can we simplify further? We note that in a graph with n vertices, if we don't have an n-1 walk between two vertices, there's no walk of greater length either. While this isn't useful if we're checking the sums of powers of A, since it would require us to find more powers, our algorithm relies on checking a single power. And some powers are easier to find than others. Remember, we can find A raised to a power of 2 by repeated squaring. So, consider our graph here. While this graph has 7 vertices and we only need to compute I plus A to the 6th, it's just as easy to calculate I plus A to the 8th by repeated squaring. And so we find... And so from I plus A to the 8th, we see that vertices 1, 4, 5, and 7 are in one component, while vertices 2, 3, and 6 are in a second component.